Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to all dinarians on the go and in the know, wherever you may be. The new CEP, Currency Exchange Planner, is a must-have for both pre- and post-RV exchange planning. The link is in the description panel below. Use the code THEDINARIAN and get the extra pre-negotiated discount as my subscriber. It is November 18th, 2019. Know that today, we are one day closer to our goal than yesterday, and we will all cross the finish line together. First article of interest. Abdul Mahdi's office, 2020 budget will be sent to Parliament within a week. 18th November 2019 1:59 AM Odd News, Baghdad. The economic advisor to Prime Minister Abdul Hussein al-Hanan, on Sunday, to send the budget 2020 to the House of Representatives within a week, indicating that the discussions are still underway and amendments by the Committee of Experts. Al-Hanan said in a press statement seen by Al-Odd News, the Committee of Experts is in permanent session to complete amendments to the draft budget law 2020 for the purpose of completing it as soon as possible and sent to the House of Representatives. He added that it is hoped to send the draft budget law to the House of Representatives within a week to 10 days for the purpose of reading and voting on it. He explained that accomplishing it as quickly as possible, the goal of voting before entering the year 2020 to be launched at the beginning of the new year to avoid the mistakes of previous years. Finished. Next article of interest. Kadu. The oil agreement between the government and the region is rejected and the parliament will determine the proportion of Kurdistan budget. 18th November 2019 Baghdad, member of the Parliamentary Finance Committee, Hanin Al-Kadu, Monday, that the parliament will determine the proportion of the Kurdistan region in the budget 2020, pointing out that Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi's oil agreements with Kurdistan cannot be accepted as it must achieve justice and equality between all components. He said in a statement to the information that political agreements cannot be higher than the constitution, as it must achieve justice among all components, especially with regard to the distribution of the budget to the provinces. He added that Kurdistan must commit to deliver the imports of all oil exported through its territory, not revenues of 250,000 barrels, which Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi agreed with the region. He pointed out that the budget of 2020 must be placed in which conditions to satisfy the people and in response to their requirements, pointing out that Parliament is the one who will decide the obligations towards the Kurdistan region and the proportion that will be allocated to them in the budget. Erbil and Baghdad resume their budget talks next week. 2019 to 17 November 13 hours 45 minutes and 7 seconds Erbil and Baghdad, the head of the Finance Committee in the Iraqi Parliament Ahmed Al-Safar, said on Sunday, that talks on the budget and the issue of oil between Erbil and Baghdad will resume next week and that there is good progress in this regard, while the chairman of the Finance Committee in the Kurdistan Parliament that there are three options to share the region of the Iraqi general budget for 2020. While the Council of Ministers was scheduled to send the draft Iraqi budget for the year 2020 to the Iraqi Council of Representatives in mid-last month, but the demonstrations witnessed in Baghdad and some Iraqi provinces have become impeded to send the draft, in addition to the discussions between Erbil and Baghdad on the draft budget delayed also, and it is not clear whether the draft will be sent to the House of Representatives or not, because the Iraqi government is currently busy with the demands of the demonstrators and did not reach a solution with our bill. Also in this regard confirmed the decision of the Finance Committee of the Iraqi Council of Representatives al-Safar in a televised statement between Erbil and Baghdad will resume next week. Our bill expressed its readiness to address all its problems with Baghdad, especially on the 2020 budget, and many meetings were held between the two sides during the previous period and in the absence of an agreement between the two sides. According to the chairman of the Finance Committee in the Kurdistan Parliament, there are three options on the region's share of the budget, from without giving details. The protests in Iraq, as well as the suspension of talks between Erbil and Baghdad, caused delays in the draft budget for 2020, and the two parties are seeking to take over the agreement on the budget and oil before the end of this year, especially our bill, which expressed its readiness to resolve all problems with Baghdad within the framework of the permanent constitution. Next article of interest. Washington announces its position on early elections in Iraq and looms sanctions against officials. 2019-11-17-21-42 Washington, Reuters. The United States will impose sanctions if Iraqi officials are found to be involved in cracking down on demonstrations, a senior White House official said on Monday. The situation in Iraq is very bad. There are many young people killed. We do not want to give the impression that the United States is interfering in Iraq, because some will use this and use it as evidence of Western intervention, he said. Lebanon, where some accuse us of being behind the demonstrations. He added, we discussed the demonstration in Iraq along with the situation in Lebanon and Syria at the meeting of the Strategic Alliance in the Middle East, known as MESA, which includes the GCC countries along with Egypt and Jordan in order to come up with a unified international response on Iraq. We appreciate the role of the United Nations and its mission in Iraq. I think it can help support new elections and review the electoral law so that the new government is in a better position to meet the needs of the Iraqi citizen, the U.S. official said. But we want to find other ways to support the demonstrators, and I think they're in providing medical assistance to the demonstrators. He said, we will not hesitate to impose sanctions on Iraqi officials, including preventing the entry of the United States and the freezing of their property. We have done this in the past with allies in NATO, adding that sanctions are an effective weapon we have in the diplomatic tools. He said the U.S. official, we are also constrained by the law of Congress not to provide weapons to the security services in Iraq if they are found to be involved in human rights abuses. Paying the military's assistance provided by the United States to Iraq, a value, and this applies to Iraq and Lebanon. Next article of interest. Reveal the date of the presentation of the new election law in Parliament and confirm its amendment. 2019-11-17-21-57, Baghdad, Euphrates News, revealed the Parliamentary Legal Committee, on Sunday, the date of presentation of the new election law in Parliament, while confirmed its intention to amend some of its paragraphs. The new election law arrived today formally to the Commission and we briefed it quickly, said Mohammed Al-Ghazi, deputy chairman of the commission. The committee held a session to discuss the bill on Monday and then send it to the House of Representatives to present it on its agenda next Tuesday. The MP from the Saran coalition, as for the position of others on the law and its objection was only on the paragraph of the electoral system, because we hoped that the Council of Ministers take into account the demands of the demonstrators and make the system individually where the winners get the highest votes. Therefore we demanded that the electoral systems are individual away from lists of parties. Whether the version that came from my presidency or the ministers will be amended in any case within the House of Representatives, and the final version of the election law will be in the hands of Parliament, Ghazi said. There are more than 30 legal experts who oversaw the drafting. Regarding the postponement of the local elections, Al-Ghazi explained, we have reached the parliamentary elections law and we have not reached the moment the local elections law. He pointed out that the provincial elections were postponed by a decision of the Prime Minister and will be presented to Parliament for approval, towards the abolition of the provincial councils. Regarding the suspension of the membership of other deputies to parliamentary sessions, Al-Ghazi said, the membership of other deputies is suspended by attending the sessions in case there are laws that affect the demands of the demonstrators. We have not waived the process of questioning Prime Minister Adel Abdel-Mahdi and there are legal procedures to follow, he said. Dedicated to the interest of the state and not to the satirists. More articles of interest to come. Hit that like and the subscribe button and check out the new CEP, Currency Exchange Planner, a must-have for both pre- and post-RV exchange planning. The link is in the description panel below. Make sure you apply the discount code the Denarian at checkout, so you get the extra pre-negotiated discount as my subscriber. I encourage you, knowledge is power. Stay informed and stay alert. Over and out for now, the Dinarian.